British in 1775, their dwellings burned, forced into ships, often separating families, and scattered down the coast of the U.S. from Boston up to Louisiana and beyond. The Acadians were not from Quebec. As you mistakenly said, though many returned later after expulsion and settlement to Quebec. Maybe it's not right. Those that escaped the British soldiers by hiding in the woods headed more northerly parts of New Brunswick and were sheltered by local Mi'kmaq tribes. That's amazing. The Acadians today are mainly in New Brunswick and the Acadian Peninsula, but also found throughout the Maritime provinces. They retain not only the French language, but also their distinctive musical style. I was doing a program on Acadian music. It's often overlooked in Canada because of the large Quebec music industry. I'm a Torontonian with a little Acadian blood who spends my summers in northern New Brunswick. Thanks a lot. That's from Susan Stanley. That's a pretty good idea. I will do that. And thank you, Susan. That was great to know you for correcting me on this. And my apologies to everyone. I'm not a history guy. I'm just kind of going by what I think I know. Okay? Thank you. Hello, I have a question. This is from Kathleen O'Hara. Is that the Kathleen O'Hara? I have a question. You mentioned that the Beach Boys more or less copied a Chuck Berry song. You played both of them back-to-back to illustrate what you meant. That was Sweet Little 16 by Chuck Berry and Surfing USA by the Beach Boys. So why was George Harrison charged with a subconscious plagiarism when he wrote My Sweet Lord and have to pay money to the publisher of He's So Fine? What is plagiarism? Plagiarism, subconscious or otherwise? Thank you so much for bringing so much pleasure and knowledge to so many Canadians. Cheers, Kathleen O'Hara. Well, let me try to explain that. Brian Wilson wasn't really a great songwriter as far as rock and roll goes yet. He was copying the High Lows and the Four Freshmen, all their harmonies. So he basically took Sweet Little 16 and wrote his own lyrics to it. Then when he got notified by Chuck Berry, he said, you're right, you've written the whole song. He gave everything to Chuck Berry. That was his own deal. George Harrison doing My Sweet Lord said he didn't know about it, but the man who produced that record was Phil Spector, who was part of producing the original He's So Fine. And he published it. So like there was money moving around there. So it's a hard call when it's plagiarism, not plagiarism, when it is. And there's only 8 notes and a few semitones in between those, like maybe 12 notes to deal with. Something's got to copy something somewhere. If you get caught, it's called plagiarism. If not, you've written a great song. That's all I can say. You were rolling on with the show. Oh, I love this song. I remember when MTV was at Much Music, a really great video on this. The backing track on this was built by many samples, mainly from Herbie Hancock's track Bring Down the Birds, from the Blow Up songs like Blow Up Was a Movie. And the Parliament Funkadelic bassist Bootsy Collin provided the guest vocals, and the rap is provided by Q-Tip from a tribe called Quest. The band is called D-Lite, which is D-E-E-E, Light, L-I-T-E, a dance group from New York City. Remember my daughter's dancing all over the house when we lived in White Rock. It's called Groove is in the Heart. The best part of the body, your heart. Groove is in the heart, delight.
The walls only covering my self-addition, my self-addition.
sing with the heart. Here's Canada's greatest singer, certainly one of the greatest in the world, Celine Marie Claudette Dion. And this song is one of the biggest selling singles of all time. It was the theme from Elfax, the movie. A song was written by James Horner and lyrics by Will Jennings, who writes a lot of lyrics for Stevie Winwood. Wrote the lyrics to, you know, a lot of Stevie Winwood stuff. So here's the great single, My Heart Will Go On, Celine Dion, 1977.
No.